need money and vibes. Don't need none of that toxic shit. My social battery gone. I gotta stay out the mix. I'm trying to be so rich. I put that out in.
Just got to the villa. Yes, I am wearing Spain top. For those of you who don't know, I actually grew up in Spain for a long time, like 4 years, 5 years, when I was younger, not far from here. But that doesn't mean that I had like money growing up or anything. My mum just landed, got a job in Spain and moved out here. But
do a little villa tour, right? Obviously I'm filming on the phone. This is the living room. It's pretty nice, pretty nice. Kitchen area. Pool area. Man, like, dang, getting some work done.
Need you, but I don't want you, don't know what to do. I can't even call your phone, your screenshot, that send it in a group. You're out here screaming, fuck me, but...
We got an Uber on the way, we're gonna go grab food, but here's the villa. So my room's down here. My boy that's coming on Sunday, his room's in there. My room, well organized. Got the running shoes ready. We're not coming here to mess around, we're not coming here to just lounge about, wanna eat good, train good, etc. Then upstairs, it's my boy Hamza's room, he got the best room. So we got a little gym. I was actually surprised, you know, they had this, that's actually quite decent. Got a sauna. Toilet, shower, little chill, downstairs, cinema room, living room type thing. And then we got huge space here. Garage. It's fire, bro. Honestly, this villa is very nice. It's making me want to stay here for a lot longer, which I probably will end up doing. Right, that's done for the tour. Just hung up the phone at night. Could already tell that you come here home intoxicated. Ooh. Day one. Now, we landed like, what, 5 hours ago? And what are we about to do, bro?
Run.
Shit, should I lock the door? No partying, no drinking, nothing like that. We come to do work, go on runs, go to the gym. All right, 5K in. Come on. But bro, look how beautiful this place is, man. You don't get this shit in Dubai. Okay, so these boys have gone to the gym. This video is so random. Just filming the trip in general. Just had to have a quick shave. My face looks a bit messed up. I'm about to surprise my sister because she doesn't know that I'm here. For those of you who don't know, my mum and my sister live out in Spain. Yeah, they've lived there for a year and a half. So my mum's gonna say like, she's going to drop off like a gift to one of her work colleagues or something. And then they're gonna turn up. Then obviously I'm gonna open the door. She's gonna open the door and go, oh shit, it's my brother. It's gonna be weird like showing them this. They've never experienced like anything, seeing this type of villa. Or like, yeah, they're just gonna be blown away pretty much. My mom always supported me. My sister always supported me. Even when I ran my first clothing brand, sat in the living room packaging orders with me at like 10 p.m. at night, like writing labels out and stuff like that. Pretty surreal to be able to do things like this now, fast forwarding 3 years later. Going where? Ain't nobody gonna think gonna be there. Keep on young, cause she gonna wanna stay. All the pretty girls wanna be gay. For those of you that don't know, I first moved to Manchester as soon as I finished sixth form. When I moved, this was after I had success with the clothing brand and I had success with organic stores. That was when I realized like I'm not going to uni whatsoever. Basically stopped going into to school to focus on dropshipping. Then I moved to Manchester the first time. This is like, I was just bang on 18. Those 6 months of moving, it was just chaos. Like it was carnage. We were just constantly partying. And I sort of got lost in the sauce a little bit to the point where I had to move back to my parents to find my feet again, back to my old hometown. It humbled me, I can't lie. Like it brought me back to realize like you can't take this shit for granted. You haven't done anything. Even now, I've not done anything. But forever grateful, man. Forever grateful. I'm literally holding this tripod right now. It's fucking flying around. But so grateful, but also yet so like hungry as well to keep going. But sometimes it's good to put yourself under pressure and go, yeah, you know what, there are people doing better things than you. So get fucking moving. You need to put your foot on the gas. So yeah, but I'm gonna stop waffling now. Fucking hell.
All right, we're about to jump in the sauna. Bro, these guys are that competitive. We end up staying in there for about 25, 30 minutes. Normally I do sauna like 15 minutes.
Yes, bro. What are you saying, Jay? You ready to get in the sauna, yeah?
Because these guys want to stay in there for as long as possible. The last person that leaves is a pussy, pretty much. Today, the sauna's at 93 degrees right now, and we're about to go in it. And, bro, I'm fainting, bro. Fuck
it, that's
the hottest sauna I've ever been in my life.
Is it cold?
Yeah.
Proper cold. Huh? Alright, so basically, we just did like 25 minutes in the sauna. The pool was supposed to be heated, but it's freezing cold, so.
Oh, I'm in an ice bath right now.
It's basically like a cold pond.
Nah. It's not too bad.
Yeah.
But it is cold. Yeah. That's definitely not a heated pool.
No.
Is it?
Yeah.
Nah.
People hate me and they love me at the same time.
Right now, I'm with a few of the Palace members. Hosted a little Palace get together mastermind type thing. I wasn't originally planning this, but when we got here, we looked around the mansion, the gaff that we'd booked for the next 2 days, and it's crazy. So I thought it'd only right to vlog it, I guess, show the gaff and stuff like that. It's pretty much the only house. Obviously you can see a house over there, but as we pulled up, we saw a tennis court literally as we pulled in. And then from there, we were like, nah. We just knew that it was gonna be wrapped. So walk up here, big long road. And when we get round, I'll show the rest of the gaff.
Entrance here, living room in here. It's nice, it's decent. Literal arcade. You've got a massive pool table. And then you've got gym in here. Proper head guards. Boxing pad, boxing gloves.
Yeah. This is my room. There's like a walk-in wardrobe there.
This is just a joke, bro. Like, who needs a bath this big, bro? And for reference, I'm 6'3", and this is like a hot tub.
Yeah, do it.
Like what? Like, bro, crazy. From here, you can see like the pool.
The pool is freezing, I can't lie.
Alright, so we've got this games room here. The owner definitely loves boxing because everywhere around the gaff is just boxing stuff. Foosball, air hockey. You've got like a little changing room to go into the sauna, which is what I'll show in a minute.
Come on, the boys.
Tennis rackets. Crazy. And yeah, I'm just looking forward to spending time with the boys, Palace members, spit some game, drop some sauce, and enjoy the crib for the next couple of days. I told her who's up.
Jeez, the boys are feasting right now.